Hi YouTubers, I'm Simi Anwar and you are watching Simi's Kitchen Diaries. I've come up with a dish which is inspired by the great Indian chef Sanjeev Kapoor today. This is a blend of North and South Indian food. Let's check out my take on this dish, Scotched egg kofta curry. Let's list out the ingredients needed for this. Quantities, measurements and detailed cooking processes are in my website simiskitchendiaries.com. To start with, I'll be preparing the kofta or meatballs first. For this, in a grinder, I'm adding onions, ginger garlic, curry leaves and roasted gram. Grind this into a smooth fine paste. Now, in here, in a mixing bowl, I have the keema or the mince with me. Add the ground paste, salt and mix it up till well combined. Add the almond meal to this. I wanted to reduce the carbs and make this a bit healthy, hence the almond meals. You can substitute this for all-purpose flour or corn flour or breadcrumbs. Now into this goes an egg and we'll combine everything together till well incorporated. The mince mixture is ready here. Now we'll start making the meatballs or the koftas. For this, take lemon-sized balls of mince mixture and spread it to a patty. Place the hard-boiled quail eggs and roll it into a ball until smooth and round. We'll repeat this procedure until all the mince is used up and the meatballs are ready here to be fried. Heat up a pan, pour the required amount of oil needed for the frying. Place the meatballs or the koftas in hot oil and fry till golden brown. The koftas are ready here, drain and set aside. You can have these meatballs just like this with some dip or ketchup, that is two birds in a single shot. Moving on with the recipe, next stage is the making of the gravy. For that, I'm heating a pan here, add some oil, pop in the whole cinnamon, cardamom, cloves, bay leaves, dry red chilies. Give a mix and let it crackle. Then add the cumin and caraway seeds. Again give a quick mix and I've started getting the smell of the whole spices. In goes the ginger garlic paste and we'll saute this till it is fragrant. Next comes the tomatoes. Combine everything thoroughly. Stick the lid on and I'll cook this till well blended and pulpy. The tomatoes have become almost paste-like. Now add the garam masala powder, chili powder and the instant coconut milk powder. Again, we'll combine all these till well incorporated. Add salt now, give a quick stir and we'll wait till it simmers. The mixture has started simmering. Now I'm going to add the nut paste. I blanched the almonds in hot water, peeled the skin and add it along with some cashews and pistachios. And that's how I made this paste. Again, we'll mix this up and let it simmer. Now I'll add some water, make this into a loose gravy. Stick back the lid on, allow it to boil till all the flavors are well infused and gravy becomes a bit thick in nature. So the gravy flavoring is also done. The next thing I'm going to do is strain this. I have a casserole here which is hot on the stove. I'll strain the gravy through a sieve. Press out all the juice till it is drained out. Add the koftas. Now time to adjust the seasoning. Some more salt is needed and also I'm adding a teaspoon of sugar to balance the flavor. Reduce the flame to low and simmer for 10 minutes keeping covered. Looks pretty and interesting. It's almost 10 minutes since the koftas have been boiling in the gravy. I'm going to add the slit green chilies, dash of butter and allow it to boil for a couple of minutes again. Now we'll lower down the flame and add the cream and cook for further 1 minute. The scotched egg kofta curry is ready to serve. The spiced koftas drenched in the aromatic nutty rich gravy is a perfect curry to beat the wintry nights. Enjoy it with some hot naan. Put in your comments and feedbacks in the box below. Follow me on Facebook, Instagram and Google+ for all the exciting updates. Do subscribe for future videos and have a great week ahead. Bye-bye.